time, but we wanted to do it in a way that really made sense out of something so deeply unsensical. Do you understand? So we wanted to do it in a way that wasn't grubby, that didn't appear unfinished, undone, and desperate. Some might think that, and that's fine. That's okay. There's many opinions in the world. But this group of kooks on this stage that Prince put together, after he passed away, after he died, which is the word we use for permanence, after he died, we were the first people we called. I know where Bobby called me. Bobby called Matt. Bobby called everybody in the band. We tried to figure out what are we going to do with all of this? What's happening here?
We need you.
Well, we need you. So the thing that was difficult about this was because we knew if we were going to do this very thing, there was going to be a huge weight on our shoulders. Where's Prince? Who's going to be Prince? How are you going to sing the songs? What are you going to do? I get it. I would have done the same thing, 100%. But we came together and realized no one will. No one will replace him. We're not going to try and be him. There won't be anybody on this stage like him. There will be people on this stage that were moved by him. So being moved by him makes sense for us to be together to do this. And then we had the grace of Stokely come on board, who Prince loved. And what is, I have to say, which is magical about this man, and you're just gonna have to grin and bear this. Well, he's Stokely. He's not anybody else. He is himself. And when he sings these songs, he's feeling what he felt when he heard them, right? Which is what you feel when you hear these songs away from this band. It's what happens when we hear pieces of music that bring us together as a community. This brings us together in the idea of uptown. This brings us together in the idea of Paisley Park. When you hear this man's music, it elicits a certain thing in us, but it allows us to be our best selves when we're amongst each other. So coming to shows like this allows us the moment to be our best selves, and for you as audience members to come to experience this music as your best selves. You're feeling vulnerable, you're feeling a lot of feelings, you're trying to deal. These are all really human, human feelings. And this is the best place to feel them, in this room, right? So we've thought long and hard about what our set list would be. You know, what are you going to sing? What are you going to do? Who's going to blah, 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 blah. So, you know, this is our first time out after this loss. And we wanted to create a set that was all about all of us together. So no one's singing Darling Nicking, and no one's doing like the iconoclastic like songs that they would be like, oh, I miss Prince. We chose songs that would involve you guys to be with us to help us get through this, right? So maybe there's not a lot of deep cuts, but that's okay. What we are is the band that sort of, I don't know how to explain it. I don't want to even say it because I don't want to get into the position of, okay, thanks. That's sweet. All right, so here's where I am at, and I won't say much, and he won't say any more anymore. Here's the magic, is that everybody in this band was 19 years old in different times of their life when they joined this band. I was 19, Mark was 19, Matt was 19, Bobby was 19, although he is the oldest member of our band. Lisa's 19. And here we are now, trying to make sense of this. So, we are at the point in the set where we have to sing the song that kind of put him in infamy, which is Purple Rain. Here's the deal. This song can't be done unless you guys are the lead singers. That's it. So I'll be your sort of bouncing ball, right? We're gonna be your silent movie band pit. Just imagine you're playing to a, you know, name your favorite. Anyway, you have to sing the lead vocals. So I'm gonna sort of stand back from the mic and ghost the vocals if you don't remember, but you have to sing. That's the only way this is done. Are you with me? We love you guys for coming out here. For real, this is a big moment for us to be here and to connect with you guys. This has taken a lot of work and a lot of mindfulness to do it in a way that makes sense. And I'll say one more thing. Bobby, I can feel his eyeballs searing the back of my head when I go too long, and I felt it about 5 minutes ago.
Purple rain.
say you want a leader, but you can't seem to make up your mind. I think you better close. Let me guide you.
See you the next time.